Good afternoon, Hume Central. Would you please give an awesome welcome to our college principal, Mr. Jeff Mulcahy.
Thank you, Mr. Sutton. Good afternoon and welcome to the first ever Hume Central Secondary College Whole School Assembly. I wish to welcome all of the family members who are present today, along with Kathleen Matthews Ward, our State MP for Broadmeadows. Today we bring together students, parents and staff from our Blair Street campus, including our English Language Centre and the Hume Flexible Setting, our Dimboola Road campus and our Town Park campus. We also welcome students from the class of 2022 to celebrate their achievements, hear from one of our past students, and we'll also congratulate our 2023 Student Voice Team leaders. Hume Central is a great school. I'm extremely proud to be principal at this school. I'll just wait for everyone. At Hume Central, the commitment of our staff to support students and families on a learning journey is evident in every caring interaction. But it is the way that our students respond to the challenge and support each other that makes this community even more special. Last year, we worked with a number of stakeholders to write a new college vision statement. We worked with parents, we worked with students, and we worked with a number of staff. And the statement that we eventually arrived at is on the screen now, which is that at Hume Central Secondary College, we aim high and strive to discover our unique talents to chase our dreams and create a successful future. I'm going to talk a little bit about that statement. So the second line in there says that we aim high and we strive. It's important that this school, Hume Central, is a school community where all staff, students and parents and carers are supported to be aspirational and to set achievable yet ambitious personal goals. But we also believe in working hard, which is what the word strive means. We work hard to achieve these goals and to make the most of every available opportunity to learn. We discover our unique talents. Each and every person within the Hume Central community does possess unique aptitudes and abilities. We need to place ourselves in challenging situations and environments in order to discover our gifts. If we do this, then what we'll be doing is chasing our dreams, a really important part of this vision statement. We all know that we have the ability to dream, but not everyone necessarily has the willingness to truly chase their dreams. So we encourage all of our students and all of our families to set goals and to put in place the changes in their lives that are needed to truly take action to make our dreams a reality. Because our dreams won't just come true without a plan or without actions. And finally, in chasing our dreams, we aim to create a successful future. Thinking about our future should provide us all with a sense of hope. So whilst success is subjective to each individual, it should be defined by our unique dreams and aspirations. We should all aim to create success for ourselves, for those we care about, and for our community. Our aim is to support all students and families to live this statement throughout each and every day of the year. So we will be referring back to this vision statement at several opportunities and helping students reflect on their journey, their learning journey throughout 2023. At Hume Central, we believe that meaningful student involvement is vital for our school to continue to develop and improve. One of our main aims this year is for our staff to know our students and their families and to use this knowledge to create engagement and connection. Our 2023 college captains are a key part of this process and they will be leading today's assembly. Please join me now in welcoming Razia Demiral and Oshina Kanoon.
Thank you, Mr. Mulcahy. Good afternoon. We wish to commence today's proceedings with an acknowledgement of the traditional owners of the land. Hume Central College is located on the traditional lands of Wurundjeri Woi Wurrung. We acknowledge the Wurundjeri people as the traditional custodians of the land on which we meet and recognize their continued connection to land, water, and community. We pay our respects to the elders, both past and present, of the Kulin Nation and extend that respect to all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples here today.
Please now stand for the national anthem to be performed by Okan Achika, our Year 10 student from Town Park campus. Thank you.
Australians, oh, let us rejoice, for we are one and free. Gold and soil and wealth for toil, our home is girt by sea. Our land about in nature's gifts, our beauty rich and rare. In history stage and every stage, advanced Australia fair. In joyful strengths and let us sing, advanced Australia fair.
My goal as a college captain is to ensure that we, as a student voice team, work together with our teachers, our peers, to strengthen our bonds, to ensure our voices and values are recognised. We also hope to create long-lasting friendships and support one another to overcome any hardships we may come across in our schooling journey together. We are all ready to reach our highest academical potentials and achieve our future goals. As college captain, I will lead the SVT to represent the student body and ensure that our college continues to maintain the safe, respectable, and supportive environment that we are proud of. Thank you.
My goal as a college captain is to continue to lead and develop a strong and an active student voice team that collaborates with teachers, students, and the wider community to improve our secondary education experience. Together as leaders, we aim to create more opportunities and build positive relationships with students across all campuses, and to develop a strong sense of belonging to our diverse school community. As a college captain, I will strive to be a responsible role model by exhibiting integrity, honesty, and openness, and will hope to inspire all my peers to always aim high and be the best versions of themselves. Our college's values of achievement, diversity, and success will guide me in my role, and I will strongly promote that learning is a lifelong journey. Thank you. Thank you all for your support and Razia, and I hope to work closely with all you all throughout the year. I would now like to invite the Bermudos member of the Victorian State Parliament, Kathleen Matthews Ward, to address the Hume Central community.
Thank you so much. It's so exciting to be here in the first ever all-school assembly here. It's just, the atmosphere is electric. I can feel the talent, inspiration, promise and passion in the room. It's really exciting. So thanks for all coming together. I'll start by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land, the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation, and I pay my respects to their elders past and present. I do love Hume's Central Secondary. You can just feel the energy here. The teachers are so dedicated. The teachers are happy, which means it's a great workplace. The kids are fabulous, and you know, I think that comes down to the support the parents give as well. And it's just such a privilege, and I feel so proud to have this school in my electorate. Today we celebrate the achievements of exceptional young individuals who've worked hard and overcome challenges to reach this momentous occasion. The parents and teachers, I express my heartfelt gratitude for your unwavering support and dedication to these students. Your guidance and encouragement have been instrumental in their success. Education has the power to shape lives and transform futures. It empowers individuals with the knowledge, skills and confidence to pursue their dreams and make a difference in the world. Hume Central College is doing a marvellous job at giving students an education that nurtures their academic, social and emotional growth, preparing them to become responsible and compassionate leaders in our community. And the friendships you make at school will often be with you for life. Broadmeadows is home to the finest people on the planet, I feel. We already know we have some of the most generous and kind communities. We have sports stars and incredible music talent like we heard earlier. And we have ordinary people working hard and doing their best to look after their families in so many ways. Today shows us that we're pulling our weight in academic achievements and BCAL too. To the graduates, I want to say that you should be incredibly proud of yourselves. Your hard work and determination have brought you to this point, and the lessons you have learnt at Hume College will serve as a foundation for your continued success. As you embark on your next journey, I encourage you to continue to reach for the stars, never stop learning, and use your education to make a difference to the world. To the incoming members of the Student Voice teams, congratulations, your new role as a leader in your high school community. As a leader, you'll have the opportunity to shape the school culture, represent your peers, and inspire others to get involved. Take this opportunity and make the most of your high school experience and leave a lasting impact. Be confident in your abilities and don't be afraid to step out of your comfort zone to achieve your goals. And I think that goes to what Principal McInerney was saying about striving, always striving and pushing yourself and trying new things and getting out of your comfort zone is really important in that. I wish you all the best on your journey as student leaders. Make the most of this experience, have fun and never stop learning and growing. Sorry. Diversity is our greatest strength, and coming from so many different backgrounds, we are showing the world that we are achieving in diverse ways too. Congratulations to all those who have had their hard work recognised through exceptional ATAR scores and university offers. Congratulations to those who have found other pathways and are already working or learning hands-on skills and trades. Success, no matter where you come from, is being your best self, whether that's studying hard or contributing to your community in other ways, through work, caring for others, using your musical talents, being a fabulous team player, or standing up to injustice and bullying. You are our future, and we are so proud of you. Thank you.
I would now like to invite Town Park Campus Principal, Ms. Quain, to commence the presentation of awards to students from the class of 2022. Thank you.
Good afternoon, students and staff, and a warm welcome to all our guests. Today, we are very pleased to celebrate some exceptional student performances from 2022. We are very proud of the results achieved by our 2022 graduates, and we want to congratulate them once again for their hard work, persistence, and determination. I hope that the success of our highest VCE and VCAL students inspires and motivates our younger students in the audience to aim to achieve their very best in every class every day. The awards will commence with the students who achieved the remarkable feat of gaining an Australian tertiary admission rank, or ATAR, of 70 or above. In 2022, we had 22 students who made this outstanding achievement, and many of them are with us here today. Some of them were not able to attend because they have other commitments, university orientation or travel. And for those, the college captains will accept their awards. Okay, we are going to start with the first achiever. With an ATAR of 70.3 and having received an offer to study design architecture at Swinburne University of Technology, François Sawa. With an ATAR of 71.85 and having received an offer to study psychological science at La Trobe University, Halima Sheikh. Next, we invite Ilona Kanun with an ATAR of 72.55. Doing architecture at Monash University. With an ATAR of 72.75 and having received an offer to study architecture at Monash University, Mia Manuel. Our next achiever is Vivian Habib with an ATAR of 72.95. And she's still deciding between medical science and biomedicine, Deakin or La Trobe. I would like to invite now Rianne Wakas, who will be doing aviation management at Swinburne University of Technology. Congratulations to Amir Shohani with an ATAR of 74.1, having received an offer to study education at La Trobe University. Next is Michelle Huynh with an ATAR of 77.35. She will be undertaking creative arts game design at JMC Academy. She couldn't be with us today. With an ATAR of 79, Darin Abu Galyoun will be studying oral health at Melbourne University. I would like to invite Gita Betarai with an ATAR of 78.5, doing law and business at RMIT University. With an ATAR of 81.2 and having received an offer to study software engineering at RMIT, Vishal Khatri. With an ATAR of 84.4 and having received an offer to study pharmaceutical science at Monash University, Sebastian View. Manisha Regmi will be undertaking law studies at RMIT University. With an ATAR of 86.55 and having received an offer to study pharmacy at RMIT University, Haida Al-Shaher. with an ATAR of 89.25 and having received an offer to study science at University of Melbourne, Miriam Alcastoma. I would also like to invite now Mina Alcastoma. She will also be doing science at Melbourne University, and her ATAR score is 90.45. Milad Abdul-Masih has achieved an ATAR of 91.9. And she is still deciding between accounting and business at RMIT University. Okay, as most of you are well aware, 2022 was the last year of the Vocational Certificate of Applied Learning, or VCAL. We are now in the first year of the new Secondary Certificate in Vocational and Applied Learning, that is VCE Vocational Major, or VM for short, or Vocational Pathway Certificate, or VPC for short. The next award to be presented is to our highest achieving vocational and applied learning student, David Barcham. We would like to congratulate David for completing his senior certificate at the college and for also completing his certificate 3 in community services. And we wish him all the best with his enrollment at the Police Academy. I would not like to announce the 2022 College Ducks along with the most accomplished senior VCAL student for 2022. First of all, our Ducks. I would like to congratulate Murabit Ali, who achieved an ATAR of 93.05 and received an offer to study engineering at RMIT University. His study scores for the 5 subjects he undertook in year 12 were truly outstanding. And this included a study score of 41 for VET information technology and 45 for further mathematics. I would now like to welcome to the stage our year 12 team leader and VC coordinator, Ms. Johnston, for a quick question and answer segment with Murabit.
So Murabit, what inspired you to achieve your goals?
The effort that the teachers put into their work, along with the competitive environment that the students cultivated, really motivated me to do my best.
What are some strategies that you use to achieve your amazing results?
Having a balance between leisure and work really helps, along with learning from your past mistakes and utilizing them in your studies.
What are some of your plans for the future?
I plan on completing my course in biomedical engineering, or normal engineering in RMIT, and advancing my career in biomedical engineering.
Perfect. Murabit, what was it about Hume Central that you found helpful throughout your time at our school?
The advice that the skillful teachers gave me really helped me organize my workloads, along with utilizing study hall time and some lunch breaks.
What was one thing that you will remember about Hume Central?
I will remember all the teachers that helped me achieve my goals and the students that I befriended during the 2022 year. They helped build a strong community in the school.
And lastly, what advice would you give to you as a 14-year-old self?
I would tell him to push yourself more and from your comfort zone, as you can afford to make mistakes at that age.
Thank you, Murabit.
The next award to be presented is for the most accomplished senior VCAL student. This award recognizes the outstanding achievements of our top VCAL student with regards to the development of communication skills, teamwork, organization, and progress in gaining experience and qualifications related to their chosen industry. This award recognizes the achievement of Alex Baruta. Alex completed his intermediate and senior VCAL certificate while at Hume Central Secondary College. He also completed a Certificate 3 in Horticulture, a Certificate 2 in Community Services, as well as a Certificate 1 in Financial Literacy. Alex aspires to become an interpreter in the future. He's now studying a Certificate 4 in Community Services and hopes to get a job supporting immigrants in Australia. And now, I would like to invite to the stage our vocational and applied learning leader, Ms. Meg Cook, for a quick question and answer segment with Alex.
So Alex, what inspired you, motivated you to achieve your goals and aim for the best?
I want to to keep my family proud of me, and also to be a successful student in the school community, Hume Central school community.
What strategies did you use to achieve your fantastic result?
I used many strategies, such as teachers' feedback and teachers' support, and also I used sleep strategy because it's a good way, to remember everything for next day of school and to have everything done on time.
What are your plans for future study and work?
I plan to be as an interpreter because here in the Hume City Council there is many people that they speak Arabic and Assyrian, and my main language is Arabic and Assyrian. I want to help them as much as I can because most of them they don't know how to speak English very well. So my goal is to support them as much as I can.
What was it about Hume Central that you found helpful throughout your time at school?
The teacher support and all the staff, they being very supportive and support everyone who need a help. And also all the students at the Hume Central, they are very well and good students.
What's one thing that you'll remember about your time at Hume Central?
I will remember two things. When we went last year on a camp and we had very good moments with our friends. And second thing, when we did a market day at the college, that we create many things to help the poor people and homelessness people as much as we can in our community, because they deserve our help.
What advice would you give your 14-year-old self?
I will give advice that we should always keep studying, because it's only way to be successful in the life.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, everyone. And over to the college captains.
Let's give these students another round of applause.
Please now welcome Year 9 to 10 band Forevermore to perform the classic Van Hanna song Jump. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. tough. I've seen the toughest all around. And I know, baby, just how you feel. You got to roll with the punches to get to what's real. Now don't you see me standing here? I got my back against the wrecking machine. Baby, how you been? You don't know what you know until you begin. Now don't you see me standing here? I got my back against the wrecking machine. I ain't the worst that you see. Now don't you see what I mean? Now go ahead and jump. You might as well jump. Go ahead and jump. You might as well jump.
Thank you forevermore for your wonderful performance. We would like to invite Ms. Aiswa Chowdhury to address the assembly.
Hi everyone. I'll jump in first quickly to introduce Aiswa. My name is Mr. Shields and I'm a teacher at Town Park over here. I was Iswa's EAL teacher in 2015 in her final year of school. And what I remember most and what I valued most about Iswa was her engagement in providing considered thoughts on the issues and ideas that we were exploring in class. She demonstrated the importance not necessarily of getting it right, but deeply thinking things through and exploring potentials and possibilities. Her engagement and participation in class not only helped consolidate her own thinking, and it's definitely something which contributed to her success, but also to the improvement of her classmates, and she cared and valued what they had to say as well. This is an observation that was shared with her other teachers, or shared by her other teachers. They highlighted her work with other students outside of the classroom. Iswa would form study groups, often running at lunchtime, which served to strengthen her skills and knowledge and understanding, but the skills and knowledge and understanding of her peers as well. Iswa deeply understood that learning is a collaborative process. It's not just a question of what can the teacher do for me, but what as a learner can I contribute and gain from others. This approach served Iswa well, and I encourage you all to consider how you can engage more deeply in your own learning, but also how you can support the learning of others. Iswa.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Iswa Chaudhry. Some of you may remember me from my time here as a staff member. Thank you. I was invited to deliver a speech today to share my educational and career journey with you all. Just as a bit of a caveat, I'm not too good at formal speeches. However, I felt like I was well suited to deliver today's speech because I was in your shoes a long time ago. And I came back in 2018 to work as a staff member here. So about 10 years ago, I was seated where you guys are sitting at the moment, unsure about what I wanted to do with my future. However, one goal that was clear to me was that I wanted to make my parents and my community proud. And I know it sounds very cliched, but I knew as an immigrant Muslim woman, education was going to be my weapon to carve out the life and identity I wanted to here in Australia. And Hume Central Secondary College provided me with the platform, the resources, the tools to achieve this goal. I'm currently working as a provisional psychologist, and I'm also completing my studies in psychology. I'm completing my doctoral in clinical and forensic psychology. What that means is that I get to work with individuals who may present with criminal or challenging behaviour, both in the community or in the prison. So if anyone of you are interested in the true crime podcast or crime documentaries on Netflix, then my work may be of interest to you. As part of my doctoral research, I'm also researching family violence within the South Asian communities in Australia. Reflecting back on my time here at Hume Central, I remember the unrelenting commitment and dedication of my teachers during my VCE years. I remember sitting at home or club and often staying back at lunchtime. I vividly recall sitting in the foyer a day before my EL exam with Mr. Shields, receiving feedback. I recall the opportunities of success and growth offered to me by the college. To share an example of how these continue to benefit me today is that I recently went interviewed for a research grant for my research, where the head panelist recognised an award which I received back in 2013 as a Year 10 student. It was the Australian Defence Force Long Tan Youth Leadership Award. I never thought that an award which I received, which I was nominated for about 10 years ago, would still bear influence on a really significant career prospect for me. I share this example to demonstrate how the opportunities afforded to us at the ages of 15, 16, or 17 continue to benefit us in our adult lives. And so a key advice for you all is to avail those opportunities and supports accessible to you through the college. To create a portfolio reflecting your strengths that will continue to benefit you out in the real world. You'll realise as an adult that you're seldom bestowed opportunities like you are in high school, and you seldom come across individuals who are as invested and dedicated to your future as your teachers were in high school. So please take advantage of that. I will leave you with a quote from Malcolm X, that education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. Thank you.
We would now like to invite the Dumbula Road and Blair Street campus principals, Ms. Eva and Mr. Baksouls, to the stage.
It is now my privilege to introduce the student voice leaders from Dumbula Road campus for 2023. I would ask the student leaders to remain on stage until all leaders have been presented. All 2023 Student Voice team leaders will receive a college pin presented to them by our college principal, Mr. Mulcahy. So the Dimboola Road campus captains for 2023 are Heidi Gilmore and Zage Tulatoa. The Balit House captains are Tony Vo and Viasola for now. The Dimbali House captains, Abdi Karim Badri Khalif and Faith Atai Owen Samesi. The Noogle House captains are Roman Tuvatai and Hayley Page. And our Tambunaman House captain is Jai Humphreys, who is currently representing the college at the volleyball competition. Thank you.
I would now like to take this opportunity to present the Student Voice team leaders from Blair Street. I would ask that all student leaders please remain on stage. All leaders will also be presented with a SVT pin by Mr. Mulcahy. Our Blair Street campus captains, Lois Jacobs and Asherina Sawa. Our Blair Street house captains, Belit, Khaled Ayach, and Anne Schuster, who is also representing our school at intermediate volleyball. Dumbali, Abdi Rahman Muhammad, and Lulu Jan. Representing Noogle, Sugal Maradi and Shay Egan. And Tambunamon, Christian Amato and Rayhan Terzi.
We are going to present our college captains with their badges. Oshina Kanun. And Razia Demirel. Thank you, and I'm going to ask the college captains to announce our SVT leaders from Town Park campus. Thank you, Oshina and Razia.
Balit House captains, Junia Kurusomi and Myrna Elias. Dumbali House Captains, Mariam Albert. Noogal House Captains, Sally Ashur and Fadi Hannah. Tambunamon House Captains, Maria Habib and Lukman Ali. Thank you.
Congratulations to all of the house captains for Town Park. Thank you. Please now welcome the college music staff and students to perform our college song, We Are One. Thank you.
Well, what a pleasure it is to play for you this afternoon. We've performed this song a few times. But today is something special because As we look around the room, we think of all the countries that our families have come from. And when we come together at Hume Central, and today is a special day, we truly are one today. And I think there's, as we've mentioned before, there's one word that that resonates around the world, but it calls Hume Central home. Do you know what that word is? Respect. Respect. That's what it's all about. All right, I think we're just about ready. So we're going to hand it over to the guys now. Here we go. Thank you very much.
Yeah. community.